Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, and if you watch one of our other movies, you would have seen the month-over-month statistics for the Ottawa real estate market, and this shows the average price in Ottawa every month, and as you can see, for about the last half year, prices have been in decline, and then for September of 2022, prices have bounced back somewhat. They actually went up 3.1% compared to the previous month. So I have more questions than answers, quite frankly. And some of the things I've been thinking about is, why did that come back up? You know, we're looking at mortgage rates right now of 5%. And it's like the world was coming to an end. And these prices started to decline as Bank of Canada rate went up, mortgage rates went up, and people wanted to sit on the sidelines. Oh my God, we now have to pay 3.5%, 4.5%, 5%. The average mortgage rate in Canada over about the last 40 years is actually about 7%. 5% can still be considered a bargain. So I don't know if people have begun to realize that, or I'm just not sure. Like I said, I have more questions. I call that a recency bias. You know, our rates went down when we had the financial crisis in about 2008, 2009, and I get why they went down. We were looking at historically low mortgage rates, you know, 2%, 3%. And I think if you're new to the market, you just got used to that. And then when you saw 4%, it looked very traumatic. And then the as you see, prices went down with that perceived trauma. So is it really a mortgage crisis kind of thing, or a perceived mortgage crisis? Or is it more of a bank failure problem of leaving a rate at, you know, below 2%, below 1% for so bloody long, like a dozen years, and then there was a failure to perhaps recognize that inflation was coming? And I remember the governor of the Bank of Canada at one point said it's just transitory, and it wasn't. So have things just been left too long and we're a victim of what we created, and then we had a failure by the B of C to recognize inflation, and that's really what's going on? Do we actually have a housing crisis? How did the housing crisis develop in almost overnight? You know, pre-pandemic, things were trucking along normally, and the pandemic hit, and suddenly we're in a housing crisis. Or is that more of just a reflection? We left rates too low for too long, and we caused our own problem, and there really isn't as big of a crisis as we think there is. That's my rant.